adventurers. Ouch. And welcome to the 96th episode of Dirty Twenty.
The year I was
love,
born.
Drum and adventure. We call a D&D podcast. Tis I, your dungeon master for the evening, and once again, I'm joined by my colourful cast of characters. Last week we attempted an alien game which was rife with technical difficulties. So this week I am trying out a new little setup, so hopefully it will last for the stream. It seemed to be fine the other day when we did another game, but I'm hoping that it will work. There are many hangovers today, so just keep that in mind. Before we jump in, we'll do our regular round of shout outs. So I'm going to kick things off with, I'm going to drop it on Mitch, first of all.
What?
Oh my god.
No, I'm joking. I'm actually trying
something different. Oh, who was that?
No.
Mondays, Natural Wonders, Twitch TV Pause at Natural Wonders, 7 PM GMT till 10. We play Star Wars, Edge of the Empire, me, Sam, Jay, and Ewan. And yeah, it's good fun. We just started back last week for the first episode of the year. We got a nice new animated intro. It's cool. Come and hang out. It's good fun. If you like Star Wars, I'm sure you'll love it.
Thank you very well, Mitch. I spelt Natural Wonders wrong. That's a great start. Am I going to do it again? Is it gonna be the right one? It is. So thank you very much for that shout, Mitch. Sam, boy.
Yeah. Sam JKP on Twitch and YouTube, twitch.tv/SamJKP. I play a lot of games and stuff.
Jesus!
We do shit.
Yeah, new game coming out in 2 weeks as well. So, I'll see you there.
Oh my god, wow!
This session's going to be great.
I'm looking forward to this one now.
JK, all right. From now on.
Naya, anything you'd like to shout out?
Yeah, so I also stream as well over on Chibi-chan. I've started streaming a bit of Faz alongside Genshin. We have a cheeky little Faz Friday sort of thing going on. We'll see if that's going to be a consistent thing. But,
Faz and Phasmophobia.
So far, I reckon it's been pretty fun. Got some spooky antics going on. But yeah, just come and check it out. Watch the stream. There you go.
And Maya lost all of her stuff to a nightmare asylum.
Worth it.
I think that's everything, unless anyone else has anything else to shout out or promote anything. Cool. So the last and final thing is our Discord, where we put stuff to do with the game and the channel, so updates on streaming times, anything that would change, or new games that we may or may not be playing. And stuff like character art, maps, and all that fun stuff. So you can find that in the Discord if you'd like to be part of that and check that out. That'd be cool. I think with that, though, that does bring us to the end of our shout-outs. So I guess then, without further ado, we should probably delve into today's episode of Dirty 20. And welcome back, mon ami. So, previously on Dirty 20, having finally arrived at Daferton, otherwise dubbed the Beacon of the North, Ferra Carta set to settling in, hopefully only for a short while. You left the ragtag and its crew along the ice dock, several miles out from the city proper, and after a chilly, windswept journey over the frozen coast, you came upon the docks. Climbing the stairs, you took your first steps into the capital and the tightly packed hovels and homes that made up the district. In an attempt to find somewhere more comfortable to stay, you passed by the large walls that encircled the royal ward, and onto the more economical heart of the city. Business was alive in the streets as you passed merchants, entertainers, and citizens. Eventually, you bought rooms at the Wayward Wanderers Inn, paying for 3 days in advance. Once purchased, you decided to spend the last of the blight over at the Gorgon's Grudge Tavern. Amid the packed spaces, you found a table looking over the tap room and spent an evening of drinking and discussing. However, the day was not without its sour tastes, with two lovers coming to a not-so-mutual parting and a bigoted encounter Guy had with City Watch. The following morning saw you taking care of business, contacting both Jala and Arilla with needed information regarding the Illithid meeting. With these messages sent, you prepared yourselves for a meeting with an unsavoury sort. Leaving the inn, you began your journey towards the Eight Ward, where the Axtons await. And that is where we will pick up this week. So, as you step out of the tavern, back into the busy streets, immediately coming upon the tradeway, just south of Edwin Square. What would you like to do?
Let's go!
Yeah, I guess it's kind of up to Alistair to direct where we're going.
Yes, you'll be taking the lead now.
Lads, we just go the other direction.
Oh, no. How many times are we going to go through this? Just walk us in the right direction.
Come on.
Fine.
Sooner we do it, the quicker we get it over with.
Just remember, parents will put up guys to make you feel welcome. They don't spend their time, unless they'll take advantage of that. I just start walking towards the Eight Ward.
All right.
I'm on the
side. Did I just hear someone
someone said,
have you ever heard of Sirenscape? Yeah. What the fuck?
Did they really say that?
Yeah, I'm so certain that's what I just
are
heard.
Are we in the multiverse right now? Are we in a parallel universe? Is that seeping through?
Alright, so. With that decision, you follow the busy trade ward down from the inn, the top of the inner walls of the city, visible. Its guards and ballistae situated at numerous towers along it. Eventually, the main road curves towards the gate, where station guards watch passers-by intently, and the occasional cart is stopped for search. Aside from curious and mistrusting looks, you're able to pass through unhindered. As you do, you step through the gate. You are greeted by the dwarfing mound upon which you had spied the palace upon your first arrival. The terrain rises sharply to the peak, upon which more stone walls encircle the glimmering structure of the heart of the city. The road leading on from the gate stretches up the hillside at a sharp incline to the base of the walls. meeting with numerous other roads following the terrain around it. Along these roads are tall, often walled-off townhouses, clearly of a more wealthy variety. Made of slate and stone, it is easy to predict that the wealthy do reside here, with houses becoming larger and more luxurious the closer they are to the palace walls. That aside, to the right of the gate you can see another market square, where most of the traffic is heading towards. Here, tall buildings with a healthy use of glass present their wares. But you continue on, towards the 8th Ward. You follow the streets, which are substantially more quiet and less traffic intensive than where you had spent the previous night. After some walking, you come upon the 8th Ward, where you had previously seen guards manning the walls. Along this stretch seems to be a new uniform. Yellow and white clothing atop polished armour. Approaching the main gate, its portcullis down, you can see etched into the stone of the gatehouse the familiar symbol of the Church of the Eight. So as you approach this gatehouse, is there anything you'd like to do? You can see on the other side, the portcullis is currently down. You can see two individuals on the other side, they seem to be in conversation, similarly dressed in that yellow and white uniform with polished armour.
Wait, so there's no guards like directly in front of us, they're just like above us or something?
They're on the, so so if you continue on down to the gate, there's none of these guards on this side, within the side that is the Royal Ward, but on the other side of the gate, within the 8th Ward, you can see they're stood just behind the portcullis, like guarding the gate from the other side. So they are on this side of the gate as you are approaching from the eastern side.
I go up to the portcullis and then I go, just wait here, guys. I'll make sure everything's all right. And I go up to one of the guards.
Okay. As you begin to approach, you can see one of them looks up towards you. And where there was a sort of slightly rested position, they kind of right themselves up and observe you approaching. Oh, who goes there?
My name is Alistair de Axon Alexander Arnold I.
Oh. I apologise.
don't.
Didn't recognise.
Worry, it's fine. I've been away for a while. I don't blame you. I've just come to tell you that I am here to meet my parents, and I've brought some companions with me, and I just show over to Ferra Carta.
They're with you.
Yes, don't worry. They're fine.
I'm not sure the Archbishop would appreciate me allowing individuals of that variety within the walls, but I also cannot deny that denying it to Axton would also be traitorous to the Order. Put me in quite the position.
Don't worry, if anyone's going to take the blame for letting them in, it will be me.
I wouldn't be too sure on that.
I'll make sure it is.
Very well. Open the gates! And he leans over towards, like, a portion of the gatehouse, and you hear, like, the squeaking of, like, a large wheel being turned as a chain, ching, 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 pulls, and the portcullis, ching, 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 begins to rise until it kind of locks in place, and the guard steps aside.
Turn over to Ferra. Alright, let's go. No. Carry on through.
Alright. The rest of you join?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I have my hood up, trying to cover most of my face after the previous night, but I'll follow in.
As you pass through the gate, you can see the guard, which, or as far as you're aware, is a guard, is watching you pass through. Just comes up, takes a step, just like a half step forward, when, Storm passes and just kind of mutters under his breath, no trouble.
Who is listening to opera?
I give him a glare with my cat eyes. I just glare.
An excellent observation. But as you pass through, there is no issue. And once the rest of you have come through, you hear the... Right, close! Chung, 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 as the gate begins to close down. As you step through, immediately you're greeted by the enormous structure of the cathedral ahead of you. Leading up to it is a cobbled path which is flanked by well-groomed grass and trees, presenting a peaceful and nature-led environment. The sounds of the city become distant background as the air fills with the chirping of birds and the rustle of animals in bushes. You head down as you do so. Coming to the end of the cobble path and approaching the main structure, you can see this Gothic-style building made with stone. Its numerous pointed spires of varying heights, similar in design to, say, St. Paul's Cathedral, with this large set of double doors at its base. Cobble road leading up to it, and some stairs that lead up to kind of like where it's slightly raised off the foundations of the ground. Attached to the cathedral, to the northern east side, you can see an extension, like a separate wing, but an architectural change, favouring more blocky stone slab walls and crenellations, more like a castle than anything else. Numerous well-armoured individuals patrol the walls and the courtyard, as you can see as you head through, small groups of them marching together, giving you looks, but not intervening. All of them dressed in similar uniform. You approach the doors of the cathedral. What would you like to do?
I'm letting Alistair take the lead on this one.
Yeah, I'm just gonna walk up behind him. You got this, huh?
Sure, why not?
We're here with you.
And is it a big double door, did you say?
So it's like massive, like probably 30, 40 foot large arched doorway. But it's one of those where, you know, it's kind of a visible presence of doors that are technically doors that could open, but there's also like a single smaller one that's carved into the main door that is actually the real entrance through.
Just stay here for a bit and I'm gonna open the little door and peek in, see if anyone's there.
Alright. You open it up. You are hit with the warmth of the interior, that familiar smell of incense crossing your nose, and the scent of home with all the emotions attached. You're effectively looking into what you would realise is the sort of like the entrance space that kind of is like an area that individuals can congregate before heading into the main atrium where the actual prayer space is, like a much like Church of England churches. As you open the door and look inside, there is a guard in there who turns his head. He seems to be seated on one of these benches along the kind of flanking walls. Gets up and takes a step over towards you. Can I help?
Yes, I'd like to know if my parents are in. Oh,
I said you were wearing your...
I was wearing the robes of Morgan. I'm Alistair Axton. Alexander,
of course.
All the best. don't worry, I haven't been here for 6 months. It's probably look a bit different.
Uh, Is there an arrangement that I'm not aware of? The meeting, perhaps?
No, I sent my parents a letter a while ago. Are they in a meeting now?
I do not believe so. I can, if you wouldn't mind waiting in here, I can prepare them.
So just I motion her to just take a look outside. I motion over to. I brought some companions with me. I mentioned it in the letter. Don't worry. If they have any problems with you, it'll come down to me.
They're all believers?
Obviously.
I trust your word. Bring them in.
I just got a woman killed.
Can we overhear that conversation? Like, can we hear that?
I mean, you're sitting behind.
I'm gonna, kinda, look at Storm, like,
believers, yes.
No talking about Mata Hari then.
No. It's okay, I can hold my tongue.
So, it's,
I wait for
the rest of you
her to go off. Ooh. And then I go to Ferra Carta to be in, like, name's Morrigan, and you're part of the Church of the Eight. That's all you need to know.
Ooh! Well, we're going to do a little bit of role play.
You've got, let's say you've got a bit of promotion going.
Alright.
We are not as stalwart as you are here with your religion. It wouldn't be such an offence to me, at least.
We have the Church of the Eight in the Isles, but it's not practiced quite as the same.
Well, I don't really care, but they do. So.
Alright. So as you, the rest of you kind of group in the space, you can see there are coal burners which are dangling down from like an arch ceiling 40 foot up. And on the opposite side of the room is another set of doors identical to the ones that you first, you just entered through. But leading off into another part of the building, which, again, you know is the main atrium. Long benches flank the walls, and you can see a long table in the middle with a presentation of different reading materials, many of which you can see are religious tales, manifestos, prayer books, hymns, everything of kind of religious requirement sat on the table. Is there anything you'd like to do as you wait?
I'm gonna read, or at least attempt to read, some of whatever shit is on the wall.
Alright. So, as you kind of look at some of the text, they're written in Trader's Tongue, or elements of Trader's Tongue. Trader's Tongue has elements of various different languages, but predominantly is the language of the First Kingdom and David, really. So you can make a bit of a hedgeway with it, but probably the only person that would actually be able to read this fluently would be Alistair, as the Old Tongue, effectively. Again, a lot of them are sort of religious texts and prayers regarding the Church of the Eight, and a completely different sort of way of expressing that faith compared to what you've seen on the Isles.
You say there's some literature on the tables, did you say?
There is.
Yeah. I'll have a look at that, yeah. While we're waiting, just a bit of light reading.
Alright. You take the book and begin to read. You can, about much the same thing, you can pick out and generally understand what's being said. There are passages and words that are of a language that you don't necessarily know. But a lot of it is duty to the faith, regimentation, not using names in vain. There's a lot of very rule specific notions within it.
Makes sense.
Yeah, they're more like rule books than actual books.
Yeah, so I was just doing my homework, just in case.
All right, well, after a short while, we'll say after around 20 minutes or so, it's going to be quite a long time, actually, now that I think about it. that same individual returns, coming through the opposite door that would have led into the atrium, walking back. The Archbishop will see you now. If you wouldn't mind following me.
Alright, let's go.
Okay. You are led through the door into a long hall filled with pews that face towards a sanctuary underneath a massive stained glass window. Patterns reflect the symbols of various gods of the Eight, surrounding a central large symbol of the church itself. Flanking the sides are upper balconies looking down into the main atrium, supported by marble columns etched with depictions of various gods. Along the walls and across the ceiling are murals presenting images of religious events, gods, and narratives. Gentle chiming and echoing footsteps resonate around this very very wide and tall space, and the strong scent of both incense, which burns in the corners, and old wood fill your nostrils.
And I think that's where we'll pan over. Where is it? There we go.
Keeping with the imagery in my mind.
So, as you step through, you can see, as part of the sanctuary at the back, there is a large wooden chair with like where the back of it kind of stretches up at least 20 foot high, and a large draping symbol of the Eight behind it, and a smaller, similarly ornate but significantly smaller seat next to it, but they are not empty. Sat in the smaller seat is a woman with sharp and pale features, signs of aging in the form of nasal lines and wrinkling skin. Her long brown hair is tucked beneath a white cowl. Her robes, white with red accents, numerous chains and ornaments adorned, and around her neck is a golden necklace with an 8-spoked wheel. Sat next to her, in the larger of the chairs, a well-groomed man with a full white beard and shoulder length back combed hair. His wrinkled face has a prominent nose and a perpetually scowled brow with very large bushy grey eyebrows. He wears a long white robe with red material trimmed with gold draped all over, similar to a Pope-esque design. On the front and back of the robes is the symbol of the Church of the Eight, as well as the symbol of Belinus. As he looks down towards you, the Archbishop, Reginald Axton, stares. What do? As you step into this intimidating space, directly in the line of sight of this equally intimidating individual?
I just motioned for Ferra Carta just to stay where they are. Take a couple of steps forward. Hello, Father.
Is that any way to greet your Archbishop?
I guess 6 months apart haven't changed you, have they?
And 6 months away, of course, you to lose your manners, boy. Why don't we try that again? one chance.
Take the knee. Greetings, your father.
He rises out the chair and puts his hand forward, which is wrinkled and adorned with rings.
I let a beat pass and I... I go and kiss the ring.
Good. What brings you home? I take it your training has not come to an end already. And you bring friends.
No. Yes.
Which is it?
You've come here looking for assistance against the Lord of the Flame. As you know, they have taken over Seal City and have reached up to the outskirts of the Clanlands. I take it you've already know that.
I'm aware of the situation transpiring in the south.
Me and my companions here we're looking to sort of bring together the rest of the kingdoms on the coast against this threat.
You wish to unite the kingdoms under one banner?
Against the Lord of the Flame, yes.
Interesting. Your quest is no secret. Word spreads across the coast like fire. What is it you seek from me, boy?
Assistance. The church is a powerful weapon we can use against this enemy, but also I would...
Weapon. An interesting choice of words.
It's how you've raised me. But I'd also like a meeting with the king.
Ambitious.
Our mission isn't... Can't come to anything if we don't have the most powerful kingdom alongside us in this. We are the ones leading the fight against them.
Huh. What an interesting notion. You wish to use my influence to acquire a meeting? Oh. I take it.
Yes, if you would be so grateful to you.
So you ask me of a favor, then?
Yes.
Our campaign against the heathens to the east is going as expected. Seal City and Valinor were faithless countries, country. They fell because of their lack of belief in the gods. And it was their downfall. But they will be liberated in time.
Sorry, you expected the front line to collapse.
Boy, you cannot win a war without making sacrifices.
You expected the front line where you sent people of this town to collapse. People who weren't fighting, people who worked in the blacksmith to make weapons, you expected that to fall.
Their sacrifice will be remembered. Something funny, boy.
Just thought of an old friend.
I hear that. I hear that part of the front line was defending a mountain pass in order to stop the expansion. They sealed it, and unfortunately many lives were lost. This troubles you, perhaps? Mm-hmm. Perhaps we should not get so attached to old friends. They do have a habit of disappearing. I see you have new ones.
Companions, yes.
You dare bring them into these chambers? The most holy of places on the coast, and bring them here.
You assume that they don't follow?
It would surprise me.
What do you think I've been doing in the past 6 months?
It would seem working for a competitor, perhaps. Knowledge of your knighthood, boy, is known here.
Knighthood is a way to use the power of that to get what we wanted. It's merely just a title. Nothing
similarly
else to
how you are wishing to use my power and influence for your own benefit.
Well, Father, it will be my power soon.
Watch your tongue, boy! Raise your voice to me again, and I will have you locked in the dungeons. And perhaps your friends will have an inconvenient time here.
If you want to punish anyone, punish me, not them. I couldn't have got this far without them. I think.
Then you are weak.
Well, yes, I've been told that my entire life. Do you think that insult actually affects me now?
It is not an insult, boy. I would not reduce myself to such petty conversational tactics. I am simply stating the truth.
Truth or not? Maybe I am weak. They've been helping me with this task. Like you said, it is no easy one.
Your training was designed to allow you to grow as a powerful individual to take my place when ready, not to rely on others. Do you think I made it to where I am by relying on friends, boy?
You seem to be the only one saying friends in this conversation.
Yes.
Alistair, you hear a voice in your mind. It's obviously Eridel. She's using psychic whispers. Please try to calm down. I know that this is frustrating for you, but no good will come of you aggravating him. Just grin and bear it for the time being. The sooner we do, the sooner we can leave.
No response. Would you prefer to have this conversation in private?
I'm perfectly happy right here.
Then, you said that I am asking you of a favor. And what I've learned, for a favor, you need to do something for them first. I assume you have many things on your mind that are too low down for you to deal with, and your weak little son could help with.
Finally, little initiative. There is a matter that may be of import, even to you. All of you, out! And he beckons to the other members of the order that are here, and shoos them away with a single swipe, and they duck into doorways and passages and head out of the room until it's empty, save for your group, you and your mother and father. Your mother, whom is sat there quietly just watching the situation, completely poker-faced. I have reason to believe we have a traitor in our midst. Members of the clergy working against it from within. You wish to prove yourself to me, boy. Seek out these individuals and publicly destroy them. They must be made examples of. We cannot allow such heresy to exist within our own ranks. And I can assure you, boy, that anyone with an ounce of traitorism will be dealt with swiftly.
That is a law that you made.
A law that must.
Do you have any suspicions?
Not as of yet.
And when I find these traitors, do you want me to bring them to you? Or do you want me to deal with them then and there?
wherever is most visible. Ensure that they are made an example of. We cannot continue to bring peace and prosperity through our faith if it is being worked against.
Very well.
Good. Do not fail me in this task, Alistair.
Can Storm, like, kind of raise his hand a little?
I shoot Storm a look of... No. I just shoot Storm, like, no.
Puts his hand down.
Your companion is persistent. What is your question, feline?
It was just pertaining matters of investigation. You say you have no suspicions, but where comes the grounds of these suspicions? It might help us.
Operations regarding movements along the front lines. Information pertaining to our most secretive discussions would appear to have been used against us. It is someone well connected.
Thank you.
Take on this task, Alistair. Take it on and prove to me, finally, that you are ready to take my place when I die. And you will become the most powerful individual on the coast, save His Majesty. May he reign forever.
One last question. When you say working against the church, is it just leaking information? What means is it that he's working against? Or they?
I never specified a gender.
Well, most of the higher-ups and the well-linked people are male. It's just my
astute observation. Whomever it is will be brought to justice. You will see to that. Or you shall no longer be at the accident.
Very well.
Good. In exchange, I will make contact with His Majesty and inform him of your most piteous request. That is all.
Rises out the seat. Puts his hand out again to you.
A kiss story.
As you kiss the ring, you feel a hand grip you from behind. And it just leans down to your ear.
Do not betray this family.
And it pulls you away. You are excused.
Very well. And I motion for Ferra Carta to leave as well.
Alright. You can see, as you head back towards the other end, that he is watching you very astutely. Your mother has not changed position the entire time, almost like a statuette. As you approach and open the door, you can see there is a guard kind of stood there, watching. And seems to breathe a sigh of relief. There was obviously like quite a lot of tension in there originally. And then just watches you if you continue to exit.
Is the guard behind the, like, behind the door? Not in the room with my parents?
In, like, the waiting space.
I wait for the door to my parents to close, and I go, one second, and I turn to the guard. Do you know if Anna is in?
She is, around. I'm not sure on her exact whereabouts. It's not my station.
Very well. I nod and leave.
Right. Head back out into the Eighth Ward. Once again, you step out into the fresh, cool air, leaving the thick tension behind.
Well, that went better than expected.
That was...
Yikes.
Civil, at least.
Big yikes.
My family, guys. They give off the great first impression, don't they?
Do your family know what something called emotions?
If they have, they haven't shown many of it.
Your mother was very chatty.
Yes, I think she'd give a gargoyle a run for their money.
So where do we even start? Do you have an idea of like a short list?
I have an idea of what they're talking about.
I think I do too.
And I hope it's not what I'm thinking.
Oh.
Well, what are you thinking?
Did I miss something?
Basically, I go to Arya, I'm basically like looking around at where the fuck we are. Like, oh, Psychic Whispers is open. Fuck.
Yeah. It's just me and you in there.
Is it something to do with a certain farming tool?
Farming tool?
Yes, I think it is, Storm.
What?
Oh, this just got much more interesting.
Guys.
What?
Discuss at the inn.
We just like farming.
I go to Erendal in Psychic Whispers. The fucking cult I'm a part of. And I see that face she made, and I'm like, yes.
Oh yes.
It's not interesting.
Mm-hmm. Much to discuss.
You guys can go back to the inn. I need to find someone and apologize to them.
You sure you're going to be okay on your own?
Oh, as long as I'm not going back in there with them, it's fine.
Okay.
Right.
Well, as long as you're closer than a mile away, you can communicate. Let us know where you are.
Is the Eighth Ward a mile away from the inn or whatever?
Where were we staying again?
I don't have a fucking key on here for distance.
Like 98 feet or something like that.
No, that's if it was in a...
Oh, right. Yeah, that would not make sense.
That'd be a very small city. Well, I'm going to say, like...
It probably is, right? Like, looking at how big David is.
Where's he?
I think it's beyond. I'm going to say it's beyond a mile.
Yeah.
Oh, it's beyond a mile.
Yeah, from the inn, from here.
The
yeah.
Portside Inn.
We're in
you're down here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That was a mile, yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought, say Portside, maybe not.
Well, that is unless you guys want to see where I actually grew up.
Of course.
I'm going to go to the actual entry of the house that I was in.
All right. So, I've closed roll 20. 1 second.
Oh no.
Oh no, yeah, I think. The camera's broken.
Oh,
it's been weird.
Don't
worry, mate. That was a little nerve-wracking,
that
one.
Oh, no.
Don't do this.
So we should approach, heading down across the cobbled road that leads through effectively this small park area, which obviously, aside from the individuals that reside, work, or guard this space, is it's separate. It's like not got any other civilians here. But you head down that cobbled path and approach the more castle-like structure that is connected to the cathedral. And approach a large set of double doors, not nowhere near as big as the other one, just literally like a normal set of arched, heavy dark wood double doors. And as you approach, I think we'll take a break there. There we go.
Good. Yeah.
Hello, welcome back. so where we left off, you were inside. You were snooping around Alistair's room. So to go back to where we were. As people that are, some of you are used to having, fairly furnished rooms, it's surprising how little is in here, and the fact that you know to search every nook and cranny, there is just nothing out of the ordinary.
Who's got the highest search?
I mean, me, probably.
Yeah, it is you.
Aria rolled a 25.
Where did you look?
I was looking under the bed, under the pillows, behind paintings. I've done this before. I've hit stuff in my room. I know where to look.
You'll find, if you look into his drawer, just letters addressed to Robin. Ooh. And from Robin, and all that sort of stuff.
I'll pick one. Just one. And read it. Don't want to be too nosy.
It's basically just talking about. So the one that you pick, it's basically just like people that obviously like each other. They haven't told each other that they like each other yet. But sort of just like friendly talk, planning to like meet up, just friendly compliments back and forth, bit of teasing, stuff like that. And then saying like, don't,
gross.
It's signed, don't worry, I know where to sneak out. I'll meet you at the Druid Park. From Alistair. Then
beautiful.
Obviously.
I'm gonna come and look over the shoulder and read.
Obviously this is, you know, it's from Alistair, so he obviously didn't send it to her. So
wow. Alistair has no game.
I don't think that's the one who what the fuck be you saying that at all.
What? You disagree?
Oh, fuck.
I just walk away.
Anyway, I'm guessing my sister's room is empty.
It is. Other than like the furnishing that you expect to see in there, you can see there is like a vanity table, which is the only additional real piece of furnishing.
Any paper? Clean parchment, like quill or anything I can write down in.
Roll me an investigation check as you search around.
And we do use the usual waiting for my sheet to load.
Yeah.
God's sake, I need to get a new fucking laptop. fuck yeah. Fuck. Anyone else want to do something while this is happening? Because it's going to take a while, it seems.
I'm going to stop.
Yeah, any more spice between Arya and Arendelle?
Did I miss something? I'm sensing a little tension going on here.
Not tension.
No tension.
No.
I just. I don't know. There's a weird aura.
The weird aura.
Perhaps it's just being in Alice's home and.
Just my amazingness.
Right, obviously.
Of course. So. This is where you grow up, huh?
I'm in the upper room.
Yeah, he's not here.
As you turn, you see the window open.
Oh, no, he's
and
not
Alistair
here.
Is gone.
I really wish there was a spell for uncomfortable moments like this.
it's called teleport.
Yes.
Guys, it doesn't have to be awkward. Don't make it awkward.
I can play the ocarina.
I would love that.
Oh, please, I've been working on a new song, actually.
I think I might throw myself off the balcony if I had to that.
Takes out Zocarina, plays a little sullen tune.
A solemn tune resonates throughout the room.
Why does this...
Alistair, as you're searching through the other room, through the desk for any letters or papers, you can hear that somber tune. And as it plays, you see like a small... metallic bin on the side where crumpled paper has been thrown in. And as you look at it, they all are beginnings of letters addressed to you. And each one is torn or like scratched over and thrown in the bin, mostly illegible. But the one that kind of is the most clearest and is the top crumpled piece, as you unwrap it and look, just says, addressed to you, and reads, I'm so lonely. And it's just been kind of crossed over and thrown in, almost like someone who wanted to say something, wanted to write to you, but didn't know what to say or how to do it, or where even you were.
Is there a quill I can see? Is there anything to write with?
There is a quill and inkwell on the desk.
I'm gonna just find, like, a sheet of paper that's like, not even if it's like a part of a paper, I can just write on, and just on the desk write it up, being like, wayward in. I'm there for a surprise. Love, Alistair. I'm gonna fold it up and put it on the desk. Then, before I fold up, P.S. I have some friends who I'd like you to meet. Fold up on the desk. And then I'm going to sneak out, and in the other room, as you hear Storm start playing that song, it instantly goes silent, and you see Alistair in the window casting silence in the area Storm's in.
Thank God.
Right.
Storm's none the wiser. He's got his eyes closed, so he can't really tell that.
Has he got his ears closed?
I thought you'd
mute
your mic.
Oh well, no! I think silence.
You can speak in silence.
Oh yeah. Right.
Just people outside of it can't.
So I won't be out here anybody.
Alright, sir. Should we get going?
Where exactly to? We're going back to the inn, yes?
Yes, the Wayward Inn.
No luck on your sister?
She's snuck out again. So.
Does she have a spot that she goes to often?
Oh, yes.
She does, but I'd like her to come and meet me from her own accord.
Right, well, perhaps you should let her know that you came and looked for
her. Yes, I've written something down for her.
Good.
God, it's more that? Tense in here than when I left.
Yeah,
hello, what are you talking about?
Oh, please, when did you all become... I was trying to think of another word, and I thought it was in my head.
Oh, meme.
Please, Alice, that. Please put that. When did you all start giving a shit?
Naturally very sensitive.
Tell me new, it's not history, Zuko.
When did you become so needlessly mean?
Mean?
You're just being mean to me for no reason.
This isn't mean. It's friendly, playful banter.
Good, friendly, then. Playful banter.
That's better. I like it like that, then.
Should we get going anyway?
Let's go. Yeah, I want to meet your sister. She seems cool.
At this point, Storm's opened his eyes, he's stopped, and he just looks at you as we're all walking away. He's like,
oh,
and, and then he leaves his own signs. What did you think? I needed opinions.
It was beautiful.
It was so good. I loved
thank
it.
You. Thank
as
you.
You can see, it almost brought Zuko to tears.
Yeah,
it did. I had my eyes closed. I didn't see that.
Very emotional.
I wonder if you performed for Alistair's parents. I think they might enjoy
if
it.
If you perform for my parents,
really? You
think
so?
You will die.
Did they really kill him?
No, surely people like them appreciate the fine art.
They threatened to execute me.
Being in that room was so tempting.
They actually said that life would be inconvenient for us as well.
Yeah, as if it hasn't been already.
Yes, but it's very sinister.
I didn't like that either.
No.
It's my parents for you.
Hmm.
Let's get out of here.
Let's go.
Yes. Far away from them.
Yes.
Alright. So, retracing your steps back through the hallway, down and out into the Eighth Ward courtyard and park, you begin the backward journey. As early afternoon begins to push on, approaching the Eighth Ward gate back into the Royal Ward. As you approach, the gate is opened and subsequently closed as you return to the main streets of Daverton. And just to clarify, you're going back to the inn, correct?
Oh yeah, I believe we've still got two more nights there, so...
You do indeed. So, with that, you head back across the streets of the Royal Ward, passing Infernus Square, and eventually find yourself passing through Crafts Bay again on the Tradeway, in the very busy and bustling midday, early afternoon business, as you pass carriages and citizens that eye you curiously and many of you with disdain as you approach the inn once again, and eventually you're able to push the doors open and enter into that building. A different clerk this time kind of watches you as you presumably head to the back stairs and up towards your luxurious rooms. So as you head up onto that fourth floor where your rooms are situated, what would you like to do?
Oh. Sit down, go up to the bar, grab a drink, I guess.
This is the inn.
Oh, I forgot that they're two separate places. Right,
yeah,
okay.
For a second.
We need some privacy for this conversation.
It's quite sensitive, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
What the hell do we do about this?
Somebody's room, I guess.
Yes, Ryan
Farguest left.
They have not. They were saying to wait until they were kind of informed what your next step up, whether or not you were staying here, whether you were going in a different direction, etc.
Yes.
Go in there, Brim, then. Let's have a conversation there.
We talked all night long. Lots of gossip.
Was that someone role-playing knocking on a door, or was that someone
actually No, that was someone actually shutting a door at some...
As in... Alright, yeah, you can approach their room. Head up towards their door.
You have the key, Zuko, so...
Of course. Oh, no. Oh, I think I left the key at the palace.
Where?
I'm just kidding, it's out here.
You're such an arsehole.
I was getting ready to murder you, Zuko.
It's right here. Boom, open the door.
Alright, you, as you go to open the door. Oh no, it's a key from a different tavern.
Oh no. We haven't returned any of the keys from any of the taverns we've stayed in.
Yeah, I don't think any of you have ever returned any keys to any of the places you've gone. You are technically like thieves.
Technically?
I think we are, literally.
Yeah, outright. Victoria sweats in every member of the Thieves Guild.
Two.
This is from Deep Bay. What the heck? Get another key out, try that one, and just go through all.
That one's from Port Minor.
Oh my god.
I still have the keystone from the
As board. You go through your list of key rings, you do eventually open the door to the room, and you can see, as you open the door, actually, just hear a... As, like, jumping on you, with, like, a dagger outstretched, is Vargas, as she, like, crashes into you. I need you to make me an athletics or an acrobatics.
She's ready.
Check.
Oh, God.
Sisters.
12.
Okay. She rolled a 17. So she, like, grabs onto you and, like, as you're unexpectedly, like, she, like... She grabs you with one hand, like, kicks your legs from under you and slams you on the ground with a dagger to your throat. Ah!
Oh, it's you.
She immediately gets up and, like, flicks the blade over and sheaths it.
You haven't done that to anyone else, have you? Oh, we were gone? No, people coming to check the rooms?
Why would that be bad?
Might be a little bit bad.
Oh, God. It's a future Alice's problem. Let's just go in the room.
I don't remember inviting you inside.
I paid for the room.
Fair enough. Come inside.
She'll head back over to the bed where she was previously sat on. You can see she's like using her blades to like carve into like a piece of wood. You also notice there is a chair slightly wonky because its leg has been removed.
Oh my god.
Rise on the balcony and kind of turns as you enter, she hears the door close behind. It's good to see you. She heads into the room towards you.
Just before the door closes, Zuko just quickly like check the hallway, just make sure no one like followed us back here. Just
roll a perception. Good idea.
Perception. 17.
Oh, what could have been?
All right. Yeah. As far as you can tell, there's no I lost my words there.
Storm, before we get started, can you do your thing to make sure we're not being spied on.
Yes. Of course. I screech my blade! Let me rise!
Screech that blade! Screech it!
Screech my blade!
Give it a little screeches.
The way Storm scratches it, you know when a cat gets to, up to a post, does
it? No. Come on!
Yeah, but light and eyes go up and I see the invisible. Into the ethereal plane.
Oh. Alright.
God damn.
As you glance with your newfound vision, looking around you, you do not see anyone spying on you in terms of like those sort of arcane images of scrying, nor is there anything invisible in the room.
Cool. Thank you. We're good.
Boy, where do we start?
So, what do you think of my parents?
Yeah, they're wonderful. They are. Just.
We should invite them round for dinner.
That sounds like the worst idea.
Yes, I can assure you, dinner with them is not fun.
So not
I
like,
bet they like really plain food.
Not like Arya's parents.
Spices.
Mm-hmm.
No conversation, just put it like that.
Oh. Just the sound of cutlery on plates.
Food and good company is one of the few pleasures in life.
Mm. Tell that to my parents. Actually, no, don't. They.
Maybe I will.
Oh my god.
Maybe I will.
You scare me, Arya, sometimes when you realize that, right?
I like it that way. Anyway, enough. What are we going to do about this situation, which is clearly a little bit tricky? How do you feel about this?
Let's just make it explicitly clear why it's tricky before we say anything else, because we're hinting at things but not exactly saying it, so we just want to make absolutely certain we're all on the right page.
I assume that the traitor that they're talking about is my, or someone close to my tutor, who is part of a specific order that is not so friendly towards the Church of the Eight.
Cult of Scythe, right?
That's the one.
Mm-hmm.
Forgive me, I do not see what the problem is. Are you worried for your own safety?
One of the laws is taking the name of the Eight in vain is punishable by execution. I've been pretending to be a part of it for goodness knows how many years, so yes, it is a problem if that comes out, and I'm pretty sure if I rat someone of the cult out, they will do the same to me.
Right.
So we just make sure that they know that it's not you.
And how are we going to investigate?
Is there a way we could perhaps make this individual forget all of their affiliations with you?
Or we could glean information from this person. There are people who can disguise themselves. Those people disguise themselves.
My parents want them to be killed.
Yes, we disguise ourselves as soldiers and publicly execute them.
Could find a way to fake
their deaths. I don't want to kill Master Shen.
What if we pretend?
I could turn into him and pretend.
Wait, why not?
You go.
He's a cult leader. We understand this, yes, that he is a cult leader.
Yes, and he was also my father figure.
Well, you've got two.
You saw. If I kill him, I've got none. You call that a father figure?
Of sorts. That it's a father
who literally taunted me, saying he sent Robin to the front line, expecting it to collapse. You call that a father?
Whatever your current relationship with your father is, we are in a tight spot. It comes between the safety of everybody on the coast and one man.
Alistair, could you just remind me what exactly that the cult worships or is about?
So basically, Cult of the Scythe is we get power from a higher spirit called Kufa, and Kufa derive his powers from the souls of the living, and cold through whatever means necessary provides them with that. In turn, they get power. The cult itself, it
doesn't sound good. It doesn't. It sounds like we sacrifice people, but in reality, it's for people who are lost, people who feel like they don't fit in. They have
the people
no
who can be manipulated. That's what cults do, Alistair. They manipulate people who are lonely, who are lost, and they use their power for their own gains.
Well, then I'm a part of two cults then, aren't I?
So are you saying that your cult fast-tracks this process of gleaming energy from the living?
I was told that saying is death is just the beginning. And what that means is that even though you have died, you use the power that you have to help those in life become more powerful so they can live on. Look, I am not at the best rapport with the cult as recent times, but I certainly have a better relationship with them than I do with my parents.
I think it sounds that bad.
You don't necessarily know that's true if you haven't spoken to them for a while.
That was the first conversation I had with my parents in 6 months.
Yes, I mean, the cult might hate you just as much.
What's their vibe? Do they hold grudges?
Oh my god, are we really discussing this, what a cult's vibe is?
Yes, I want to know.
Well, from the reading I did, that they were made out to be not threatening.
Basically, the people lower down in the cult, just normal people. It's not like we go there every week and sacrifice, like, the firstborn son of a noble. We go there to just be a part of a place where everyone there has nowhere else to go. And yes, it has hierarchy and structures, and there is an inner circle, but they very rarely bad things to lower downs, unless you deserve it.
And what do you count as deserving it?
Going against the cult, pretty much.
Isn't that exactly what your parents do?
Yes, my parents aren't a part of the cult, funnily enough.
It's literally the it's same thing, different shapes.
Yes, and like, do you not think the cult knows that I'm a part of the Axton family? They know. They know who I am.
They accepted you anyway.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. When my parents didn't accept me for who I was because I was apparently weak, even though I was too young to use magic. Asashan caught me then. Even though I wasn't a part of it to begin with, I was accepted. And yes, it might have been manipulation, or as you say, them taking advantage for me, but I liked it. If it was it, I liked it, because I felt a part of something that wasn't there. Look, I don't like this situation as much as you do, but I don't want to kill Astashan.
Well, we don't then. We find a way to handle this.
Find another way.
Another way. But we do need to handle it if we want the assistance of your father, or can we bypass that somehow? Do we need your father? Is there some other way that we could see the king?
We see the king without doing my father's favour, now that I've accepted it. Anything we say to the king will be null and void.
Well.
Okay, well, we could always... This is a little dubious, and actually...
We're not kidnapping people in your lamp.
No, no, I never said that. I never... Good idea, but I didn't say that. We could always... This is very, very offbeat for me. We could always frame someone else.
Oh.
I was going to suggest something very similar.
That's
going to frame an innocent person.
Awful thing to do. Well, it didn't have to be an innocent person. They could be a bit of a dubious character.
Do you hear yourselves right now? You are talking about framing an innocent person rather than an actual cult leader.
Well, we could find someone who's a bit of a fiend.
Do the whole I could pretend to be him and we could fake his death.
There is also that.
Mm-hmm. I'd rather not put you in that situation.
And if we get found out for using magic.
Is changing magic?
My natural ability is a little different, but my ring, unfortunately, it is magic.
Will your parents see it that way?
I think the fact that they are not very welcoming to people like me and Gaiac means...
Yes, they're not going to like it.
They're not going to like a changeling either.
Exactly.
But they would never know.
But they wouldn't know. I would be Astoshan being killed.
Mm.
Perhaps a good first
I feel
step
like they would want to display his body as well. So
that's not great.
No,
perhaps
that's
a good
dark.
First step would be talking to this.
I would very much like to meet him.
We don't even know if the person they're referring to is the cult.
Yes, we are jumping to
conclusions.
Of course, it is likely, but it's not guaranteed.
Of course.
How do you go about finding a traitor? Ask around.
How did we do it last time? We,
We found
it. Yes. Was it in the fire? We should look in fires.
Look into the flame, and it will show us the way. I shouldn't say that.
We could do a stakeout. Oh, we could do a stakeout of the cathedral.
Last time we did a stakeout, didn't you like stay under a bed for like hours?
I did, but you know.
Do
what we gotta do.
I would like to do a stakeout. That
it would be fun.
Fun.
Zuko, what do you think a stakeout is?
You get.
please continue.
Please carry on.
Sentence.
Yes.
You get this, you get a nice meal, and you go out and eat it together, and then you maybe catch a criminal doing something.
That sounds like a great first date.
You and I have very different opinions on first dates.
I mean, I've never been on one, so I just made it up in my head.
Really?
You've never been on a date? That's not the important thing right now.
Hey, you can't just mention you've never been on a date and then we just skim past it.
We don't have to. We just have to wear right now.
Did you just call him a virgin?
I never said that. I just never said
that. Oh, Eridel did.
Eridel.
Oh.
What?
I heard you calling him
Is
a virgin.
Is there a problem with being a virgin?
Did I say that? I don't state it a fact.
It sounded like you were making fun of him, but okay.
Moving on.
All right.
We should probably talk to the mentor and see. But do we want to alert him to the fact that potentially he's being investigated?
I think we should do the stakeout first.
We should find out what my parents are talking about the cult first, and then.
Yes.
Oh,
do a stakeout.
We could snoop around in the.
I mean, I could literally just sleep
there for the night.
House.
Yes.
And if anything suspicious happens, I literally have a way from my house to the cathedral.
Just be very careful and not don't.
Well, if it is a part of the cult, they won't do anything to me.
We have to go on facts here. They believe. It's information being stolen about the front lines. If we can find out when even the next meeting is, I can always have my little eye there.
This is true.
Again,
can't you move your eye?
It's the risk of using magic.
Oh, but I don't have to be anywhere near it. I can be in this room and take it all the way there.
Wait, how far away can you be from it?
Oh, I can send it to the Dune Lands if I wish.
take me a while, but...
Great reception.
Mm-hmm. Right, so we could literally just have... I wouldn't have the eye in the cathedral. Just in case.
It's invisible.
Yes,
do you know if...
The cathedral does have defences against that.
That's what I was wondering. Does it have anti-magic stuff?
It's not anti-magic, but I'm pretty sure they'll be able to detect unspiritual magic in their own way. But we can definitely have it in the 8th ward outside the cathedral. But if anything suspicious happens there.
But regardless, a bit of snooping is in order.
There is a law against that that will get you executed if you get caught.
Against what, sorry?
Not from sleeping. At risk.
We have been asked to investigate.
Yes.
Under the... Yes.
So it wouldn't be out of the ordinary if we were caught snooping.
But we shouldn't we should try not to get caught.
Of course, yes, but we have a fallback if we do.
I wonder if they would deny it.
What exactly is Axtoshan's official position here?
He's a mentor to the Axton, and he was for a time before he stepped down of his own accord. A right-hand man to my father, when my father first started.
Well, what is he called?
So you don't think that he would be able to glean a lot of information from your family and your...
No, that's why I'm scared it is him.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
But what is he called?
It probably is.
Who else?
Just before we go ahead with this plan, your family hasn't specified... what we're looking for, who we're looking for, what the crime is, just information about the front line, which, honestly, anybody in that room could like potentially...
They did it that way.
And their most secretive of conversations were being leaked.
If this is the case, surely we just need to find somebody who is a traitor. Your mentor fits that role. I'm not saying that we should kill him, I'm saying that the swiftest way to get a meeting with the king would be to present him as a traitor.
We are running into
and
a bit
then
of
he will
killing
be killed.
Him.
Which, yes, that
there
is.
Will be a obvious. There will be a rather significant complication, that though, in that he can.
And if I get him killed, I'm pretty sure the cult will.
You could lie. You could say that you joined the cult to glean information.
Wait, sorry.
I'm saying the cult will have a problem with that.
What were you going to say, Kensei?
If we take him in, then he will likely be interrogated and may even reveal without much effort if it would get him a mitigated sentence, Alistair's involvement with the cult.
Yes.
His parents are clearly
already looking for an excuse. He knows he's going to be executed anyway.
His parents are clearly already looking for an excuse.
Yes.
Whether they may just take it, whether they believe it or not.
And Alistair, not to insult you, you're quite rebellious. I don't think it's too far-fetched for them to believe such a thing.
All right, then. If we do stake out and find that it is him anyway, then we're in the same position as we were before.
Of course, but at least we know.
If we find out it's someone... who isn't affiliated with any of them, even better.
Who else do you think it could be? Is there anyone in your mind that stands out?
Military commanders make the most sense. They would be in charge of troop movements and understand.
Unless there's someone who was, like, on the front lines that somehow made it back and wants to...
But who would be involved in the most secretive of conversations?
Any other advisors or people your parents are close with?
That's who we'd need to look at.
Yes.
Well, I'm happy to stake out the temple, the cathedral.
See if we see anyone suspicious, you know?
Yes.
Can we start tomorrow? Tomorrow? I sort of left a letter for my sister to meet us here.
Oh, sorry. I see.
DM, real quick. Did we hear how long ago the front line was attacked or fell? Do we know how long
it fell about like 4 months ago if we've been away for 6 months.
That location, at the along the border of Belenor, yes, but there are other sort of like front-lined areas.
And it's only been about a couple weeks or a month since we met Astashan, right?
It was in Deep Bay.
Maybe a month or so.
Okay.
Probably maybe just over a month actually, because you've travelled quite you've done a lot of travelling since. You were at Deep Bay, so yeah, I would say it's probably over a month.
I think it's important to establish everyone's whereabouts, where they were 4 months ago.
Yes.
Astashan is currently almost likely suspect, not the only. You must understand the idea that he may not be the only one.
Yes, I agree.
Is there any eventuality that where this is one of your parents?
That would be juicy.
Oh, I wish it was my parents. Like to do a lot against that, that'd be brilliant.
If it was one of your parents, then why would your father ask us to root them out?
Because he is a sick man who likes to play games. There's a reason he didn't hardly give us any information.
Right.
I definitely got that impression.
I'm just going to go to the balcony and just check no one's, like, spying on us from outside.
Sure. Run over perception, Jake, as you head over.
Feeling a bit paranoid in this goddamn city.
Yeah, man.
You should do.
Yeah. Good, yeah.
17 good. Again.
17.
Ha! Great film.
That little laugh.
Give me 1 second.
Of course.
What the fuck is he put in this chat?
Interesting. So, as you head over to the balcony, you walk onto where you can see the street below, and there's a lot of activity going on. And just look casually just to see if anyone's watching, kind of interested with your sort of your room, shall we say?
Mm-hmm.
Looking up. You don't see anything. It looks fairly normal down there, just people walking past. It's busy, so if there was someone watching, it would be difficult to really see them. But that is until you see something in an alleyway opposite. A very narrow alleyway. Just see a figure in a bluish sort of cowl disappear into the darkness. As they kind of have noticed you looking down and have caught sight of them, they vanish into the shadows. But with 17, it's not enough to discern any features, just that it was a form.
Is there like curtains that I can close to cover this?
100%. Yep.
Step back in the room, close the curtains very quickly. We're being watched. Perhaps.
Oh, great.
Individual blue cowl? Does that sound familiar? Is that some kind of guard outfit or cult outfit? I don't know. Blue cow?
Blue. Oh.
Blue.
Wait. Blue?
Blue.
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 Blue clues.
We remember.
Oh my god.
This is a throwback, but I actually can't remember the colour of it. But our mate from Seoul City used to wear
green.
Ah, green cloak. Yeah, not blue.
Yeah. They were watching from an alleyway. They stepped away as soon as they caught.
Would they have been able to hear us?
Who knows?
Unless they have supersonic hearing, they were there on the ground. But nonetheless, they were watching the room. They're probably long gone now.
They were watching Tommy Wiseau?
I do not know what that is.
Kenza, your voice changed.
Sorry, I had something in my throat.
I mean, the cults wear like dark robes, but they're more black than.
Could it have been your sister on her way? You didn't
perhaps
invite her here.
Yes.
Why would she turn away?
I think it looked more like a gentleman, but I'm not too sure.
I must have a secret brother I don't know about.
The plot.
I could go and have a look if you like. See if they're still there.
I mean, you could try, but I imagine once they've been spotted, they will just scram.
Most likely long gone by now anyway.
Probably.
Can't hurt.
Which way on the map would they have gone, DM?
I don't actually know where we are on the map.
So,
here are
you are, yeah, somewhere around there. So we'll say on that blue building. It would have seemed like disappeared down an alleyway in this sort of direction opposite you on the other side of the main road.
Like down here?
Would have been more of a smaller alley than that. That's a fairly wide one.
I could get over there quickly, but last time I flew here it didn't turn out well.
Yes, I don't think it's a good idea.
Don't go flying.
I think it's just something to bear in mind. We have eyes on us. Not sure what from, though.
Most likely Alistair's father sending somebody to keep an eye on us.
Yes, Alistair, are you sure you don't know what blue robes could mean? Blue cow?
Would I know from memory, DM?
Roll me a history check.
My robes are blue, but don't know if it's like a cow. History? Five. No.
You made them
specifically out of blue cow. It's not a good enough description. Just blue, blue robe, blue cloak thing.
Just a blue robe, it's not very descriptive, is it?
No.
You could get one from down the road.
I've been wondering, Alistair, do you know of any kind of undercity presence here? Does it exist? Or?
I know. I think the Laurel Guild is in this town, but it's like less of a foothold than in Steel City. Is that true?
Sorry, say that again. I was just.
Isn't there like a part of the Allura Guilds that's part of this town, but it's like less of a foothold than Steel City?
It's got less of a foothold here now. Mm. But yeah,
I mean, there is
at this point, Storm, you see a kind of like luminescent purple spot here in the room above Zuko.
Okay, I'm not gonna directly look at it. Oh, God, I can't.
But did it just show up?
Wait, above
just showed up.
Oh, above me. It goes. Yep. Wait, go. It just stays there.
Shit. It just appears above Zuko.
I'm gonna nonchalantly, like, not like looking like I'm looking directly at it. Nonchalantly, like, gaze my eyes across everybody. I don't want to see if I can recognize if it looks like a scrying eye or anything like that. No.
Romy and I kind of check. I think on this one.
Because you can't. It's a shame you can't identify.
Doesn't the spell tell you that it is?
Wait, no. See,
invisibility
doesn't. Swear, no, it has no word. I don't know. You can.
See what you know that scrying typically appears as a little ball, right?
Ball, yeah.
How it appears.
You would know that, though, right?
You can make the assumption, but I'm still going to make you wrong. I can't. Yeah. I already have. So yeah, you can make the. You could come to the conclusion that it seems like it might be a. Like a scrying orb. However, something a bit weird about it. The magic's weird.
Don't like that.
No, I don't like that at all.
Don't like that at all.
Question. Oh, no, I wouldn't. No, I can't see it, can I? Never mind.
No, only Storm can.
So, perhaps...
Are you at this, Storm?
Yes, I'm fine. We seem to have the mice in our rooms. Can you? You can't see them, but I can see the little mice scurrying around. Yes.
Isn't that a good sign? Because it means the room is warm.
I'm going to just.
I'm going to
say in psychic whispers to Aridel. I think it's best if we get the entire group in.
I would like the insight check Storm to see if I can pick
yeah,
it up.
I'm
just about
that
to say I kind of want a performance check from Storm.
Everybody
yeah.
in.
yeah. I can...
I'm gonna let.
See how believable that is.
I'll do performance. Yeah, ready.
Can you do that? Can you just add people to it?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
16.
Right.
I can have up to 5 people in there.
You can
pick and choose.
I'd say you guys could probably get the vibe. He's made allegories like this before.
Cool.
Yeah, that's. I've not shared out to put people in the whispers.
Ah, I see.
I'm gonna let everybody in. Except Arya.
So petty.
Keep going. Keep going. Two can play that game.
Oh, God.
I don't want to play it. 20 episodes time, the most angry makeup sex ever. Like.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Why would you even say that?
It happened. I mean, do you want me to do an insight check to see if I pick up on the cue?
No, it's fine. Okay. I'll say you can pick up on it.
So yeah, I'll say in Cyprus, yes, we are being watched. I don't know if it feels off, though. It's not like a...
All of you detect another presence in that psychic whispers.
Oh, no, it's Belinda.
It's Belinda.
I bet it has to be. Who else
would
it be?
It's like
the Mind Flayers.
Insight check it, try and get the vibe of what's going on.
Roll me an Arcana check, because you're getting nothing other than just like that feeling. It's like when you're in a room and you get that feeling you're being watched. It's that, within that space. It's almost like there's an invisible person stood next to you listening in on the
I'm gonna add one of my psionic die to it as well then. Right. So it's D8. Ooh.
So the 23, you've been probing with your psionic abilities for quite a while now in terms of like meditation and really pushing them to new heights, and you're beginning to understand it a lot better. You are 100% feeling the presence of another psionic. In addition, it's not that they are in the psychic whispers necessarily, but you like the way in which it's weird because it's like someone's listening behind you as opposed to everyone else being involved. So actually, I'm going to say I should take back what I said earlier on. All of you don't feel the presence, but Aerodel does. It's you don't have this spell necessarily, but it's almost like someone is reading your thoughts and by extension is now able to listen to your psychic whispers.
The phone's tapped.
No.
It's basically that your phone has been tapped.
Not even psychic whispers is safe anymore.
But by who?
DM, give us any takes.
Well, we better learn sign language.
We would be talking normally though, so I would have said.
We don't know.
You don't know. Only Aerodel knows it.
What is this?
I have no way of checking who it is or what is listening to us.
We should just lay low for now.
I'm gonna wait. Hold on a second, Ewan. You said that I could sense it, but
we can't. Sense it.
No one else can.
I'm going to push everybody out of psychic whispers. I'm going to shut it down apart from
perhaps we should
that one present, or at least try and bleh.
I know what you mean.
Shortest voice chat ever.
What was Rushi hung up on us?
He was a salesman, sorry.
Okay, yeah, you immediately, all of you were having that conversation. It's cut short.
Yeah.
Huh?
What?
You are there and you hear that, you feel that presence there.
I'm gonna ask it in psychic whispers to make itself known.
Okay. I need you to make me a wisdom saving.
Oh, baby! Let's go!
You poked the bear.
Just so that we're not all like seeing awkwardly, I'm gonna quickly just like make the bed and act normal or do something normal.
Yeah. I'm gonna like pretend to be looking for the mice.
Yeah.
All right.
So that we're not just standing there and just
terribly
act
out some kind of comedy routine. Aerodel, you feel like that presence trying to probe your mind and like look for information. It's almost like someone's trying to take your brain and look through a filing cabinet, but you slam the door shut and immediately the presence dissipates.
Oh.
Are you okay, Aerodel?
Something was in psychic whispers.
Is the purple energy still there, did you say, or it's gone? Did it flash for us, or did it just disappear just a few moments ago?
It disappeared probably just now.
Just now.
At the same time,
it's gone, whatever it is. It's not there anymore. Whatever you did, it... it caught wind and left.
We're still being spied upon.
I don't like being spied
on. No, the orb disappeared. The orb disappeared, right. That's what you just said.
Right, okay.
Could I make a connection? The fact that she's not said anything yet, but the fact it's purple, and I know...
Roll me an Arcana, yeah. Roll me another Arcana check.
It's got that vibe in it.
Can I do that now?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. It's nothing sacred. Oh.
Right.
I think the bathroom is.
I mean, you can certainly attempt to make some assertions, but you've never seen anything like this happen before. Not in that regard. You know that people can like use telepathy, but her telepathy is like a very specific skill. So jumping in, I would say that you're not necessarily aware of what has happened with her.
Yeah. Oh no, not with her, but with the purple aura itself. If I could.
Yeah. So you could theorize that it might be that, but you're not confident that that's what it could be. You've seen various versions of the orbs. Just its coloration and energy might not necessarily be a giveaway.
Tom.
Yes.
Is that thing gone?
Yes, it left moments ago. Actually, not long after you pushed us out.
Is there a connection?
Can you send a message?
I think I see where this is going, yes. I am able to send.
Ask her if she's spying on us.
I'll make it short, since I do not appreciate being spied on. Are you spying on us, Belinda?
A moment goes by. I asked for no more calls.
Okay.
If I was, do you think I would tell you?
Good one.
Good question.
No.
I fear her.
I'm not interested in your group.
I fear her so much.
That's the end of the message.
Okay. I really need to stop calling her.
Calling you.
She made a valid point. She does not care, and if she was spying on us, she would tell us. So
it wasn't. It's pretty valid, yes.
So it could be, it could not be, but she sounded pissed off.
Okay.
Obviously, you haven't been missing many psionics. Is there a thing they can do? Can they just enter psychic whispers like that through their own choice?
Or I would
read people's minds? I don't know.
Yes, that is definitely something. With enough training in psionics, you can alter someone's entire perception of the world around them.
Reading minds is something not even exclusive to psionics, so imagine what a psionic can do with such progress even further, I guess.
The mind is a powerful thing.
You okay?
I think so. I'm just not sure.
Next time, let me know when that happens. I have an idea on how we can try push them out if they won't leave.
Well, that's the thing. As soon as I asked them to make their presence known, they disappeared.
I have a feeling they, whatever it was, could stay longer if it wanted to.
This situation has made it very apparent that maybe we need a code if something is spying on us.
I agree.
What about mice?
That's...
Mice is good.
Mice is a good one, actually.
The mice. But the form of the spying is often different. Sometimes they can see us, sometimes they can only hear us.
We can say mice is if they can
if they're scrying.
And if it's they can... Wait, yes, mice if they're scrying, spiders if they are...
Or we could just say, I could hear mice, or I could see mice.
Ah, yes.
Yes, I have a idea.
What's a good idea?
Your code word should be... murder.
Oh. I told you, we don't do that here.
I mean, it's to the point.
The problem is, the person is obviously quite intelligent. They're going to realize eventually.
Yes.
We can change it. Doesn't always have to be the
every
same.
Fortnight we should change it, and yes. it should contain
every 72 days.
Special
we are definitely going to forget that
every time that we use it, that someone is spying on us, we then change it afterwards.
Yes.
But it's just far too complicated.
It's not complicated at all.
It's a matter of life or death.
We use it until they catch on,
yes,
and then we change it.
And then we'll change it. Simple.
Were they only in your wait? Question. Did we feel it in our? Like, no, it was just Everdell that could feel. What, do you think? Oh, wait, did you tell us it felt like someone was reading your.
I said that somebody was in psychic whispers with us.
Does that mean they were just attempting to read your mind, or were they in ours and we didn't even realize?
They may have been looking for some specific information.
They would have been able to hear.
The whole bond, I assume, yes.
Well, that takes away from. Parents spying on us. Just psionics.
Do we have any plans for the rest of the day?
Unless we want to do the stakeout tonight.
I was going to stay here.
You don't have to.
Is she anything like your parents?
No, she's like Aria.
I want to meet her.
I won't be long. Just give me a moment. I'm gonna leave and go to mine and Alistair's room.
Before you leave, I'm just gonna catch you at the door. Adele, one thing I want to say. Thank you for earlier calming me down.
It's fine. We wouldn't have gotten anywhere if you'd have blown up anyway.
Yeah, but. At least you did it.
Can I go?
Sure. So, just gonna re-enter the room and just wait.
Alright. What about the rest of you?
Yeah. Chill with that. I'll settle.
If the conversation's over now, I think I'm going to go back to mine and Aria's room for a bit and just stand on the balcony and then head down to the bar in like an hour or whenever and see if his sister's arrived yet. Oh, no, wait, she's not coming to the bar, is she?
She's coming to the inn.
All right, I'll go back to the room in like an hour or two and see if she's there or not.
All right. So, you have a few hours to do something if you wish.
I'm going to do one thing.
Sure.
Inside the room, I'm going to cast invisibility on myself.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to stand on the balcony for an hour and just see if I catch that person, come back and have a look.
Mind me another perception check.
Good idea.
Don't you cast it at a high level?
If it's it would be at a high level, yes.
So it'd be like 2-3 hours?
I think when you higher level cast it, it just means you can time.
Means you can have more people. Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was more time fair.
Yeah. Did you say perception check?
Ooh. Oh, stinky. No.
I'll add a d4 from a special thing, but. 4.
I mean.
7!
8! Alright. So you spend a few hours there watching, and every so often you're kind of like at boredom as a. Doze off. A couple of times you almost knock yourself over the balcony from falling asleep. But managed to catch yourself that sensation of falling. As you watch for that period of time, you don't see anyone that matched that description return. You just see kind of the traffic beginning to dull down a little bit, and then as later afternoon rolls around, they begin to flood people begin to flood the streets again as many places of work finish and people head home to bars and taverns and the like.
Just because I am also like on the balcony of the room next door, I wouldn't specifically be looking for anything, but like, is there anything I notice while I'm just kind of staring out?
I mean, roll me a perception.
22. That's ooh, the best wait. I've ever rolled.
That's, yeah.
You see me invisible.
Zuka, you're not very discreet. I can see your clothes. The loins.
Your loins are showing.
Probably about the same. The kind of swelling and then dilution of people on the streets, but nothing stands out to you or comes as much of a surprise.
Okay.
Is there anything else anyone would like to do with this time as you wait, however long it may or may not be?
Cool. Right. Yeah, that was fast. Jesus Christ.
So when Eridel leaves the room, she's gonna like, you know that awkward, like, half run, half walk that you do when you're, like, trying to get somewhere, but you're trying to be, like, kind of discreet about that? She's going to do that along the hallway, and then she's going to shimmy on down the hallway.
Down the hallway.
she's going to shut the door behind her and lock it.
Alright.
And she's going to... there's a mirror in the room, right?
There's a mirror in the room.
Right, she's gonna Eren Jaeger stand over the mirror.
Takakai.
And she's gonna like knock on her head. Listen here, you little shit. I know you're fucking there. I'm just gonna like wait for a second.
Oh my god.
Grab the bull by the horns.
Nothing. Really is poking the bear.
Nothing.
Trying to think, is there anything that I can do to like sense like the presence of anybody else?
Don't know, is there?
Let's have a look.
Got anything in mind?
Only thing.
Oh.
No. I've got danger sense. Danger sense.
That is specifically to like physical interactions, but what are you trying to achieve in this situation?
I am essentially question. In. I'm trying to sense if there's another psionic in the area, basically.
Okay. So you're trying to put out your, like, sense to see if...
Yeah.
Anything happens, alright. Roll me a charisma check. Let's see how it goes.
Can I add a die to that?
You certainly can.
Cool. So I'll add a d8 to it.
11. You close your eyes and try to like put that sort of sense out there to just try and hear the voices around, to hear anything. But as you try to use your psionic ability, it just feels drained. Like whatever had happened has like mentally drained you. And in this moment, it's just like you try to access it and you just get... really not painful necessarily, but a very uncomfortable headache that just stings a little, and it's hard to focus, and you just lose control on your concentration on it.
Can I still produce my daggers?
Yeah, you produce them. They flicker a second as you produce, only from like the kind of the intention of the moment, but they still appear.
I'm gonna...
It doesn't look like you're losing your ability.
Okay.
you feel that confident about that as much.
I'm gonna produce one of my daggers and I'm gonna hold it up to my forehead, like I'm gonna like hit myself in the forehead with it.
Okay.
I'm just gonna like look at myself in the mirror, like I'm basically like looking at what the fuck is ever going on. Like, come on, like.
Mm-hmm. As you hold the blade up, it shimmers. Your hand, like between your, with the blade between your eyes, directed towards your forehead, it creates like a cross section, and your left side just appears to shift as you watch tentacles flop from your cheek as your skin turns purple. And there's a moment of like shock in that moment, and the blade flickers and you look away and you're back to your normal physical appearance. But you just feel like what was once like a little tickle or an itch at the back of your head. Feels like someone has taken a needle and is just like slowly pressing it through where your brain connects to your spine.
Really?
And it like continues and it gets more and more intense.
Oh!
I'm gonna need you to make me a wisdom save.
Oh no! No, my god!
It's happening so smooth.
Use your dice, use your dice.
Yeah, I'm gonna use my dice. I'm on like, oh fucking hell.
I am stressed.
Here comes the invasion.
Oh god.
Okay.
Okay, 13.
The world
you begin to sweat as you like drop to your knees. Your hands are shaking, and like an intense sense of fear runs throughout your body, and your eyes turn to black and you fall unconscious.
Oh no!
And none of us know.
Oh no!
Well, shit.
What have you done?
You press the button.
You've poked the sleeping worm and just woken up.
Oh my god.
God damn. Why?
Well, if it isn't the consequences of my own actions.
And I think on that bombshell, we're going to take probably our
last
one. Oh
my god.
Welcome back. Yay. Where we left off, Eridal turned into an elephant.
We laugh now.
Eridal decided to push a button again. Whilst the rest of you, some of you were out looking over the balcony, and the rest of you were still in the other room. So, a couple of hours go by. As the sun begins to set in the sort of mid to late afternoon, and eventually, as the sun wanes and twilight begins to leak into blue and purplish sky, covered in clouds, you begin to hear like footsteps up the hallway. Did you give a specific room number?
I just said Wayward.
Actually,
in.
They would. Yeah, they
ask
would
her.
So, first of all, this is what would happen. You'd hear footsteps up the hallway, and then you hear a knock at a door. It's not your door that you're in. It is the room that Alistair and Eridale have. Purchase.
Oh no.
Oh no.
I'm gonna. Do I hear the knock?
Yes, you would hear
it. I'm gonna open the door as adjacent to her and look out.
Alright, as you open the door and look down the hallway, you see a young woman with fair skin and black hair, which is currently cut into a tight bob style, stood at the door to your room. She's wearing a long green cloak with the hood kind of partially covering her face. She is clearly recognizable to you, even from like just a side profile. You recognize Anna immediately, although she does not necessarily instantly see you. As she hears the door open down the hallway, and does turn towards you. I'm just putting the image in the Discord. She turns towards you, and her eyes just kind of widen in surprise. She was expecting this room, but
wrong room number.
Alistair.
You alright?
Yeah. She runs over towards you and just kind of like... She like gives you a hug, wraps her arms around you, and then kind of pulls away and punches you in the shoulder.
Ow. What was that?
For not writing to me.
Did you write to me?
Well, I didn't know where you were. You were gone...
That is everywhere. That is true, yes. But I'm here now. I'm guessing you got my letter or paper.
I did.
Where were you?
I saw it. Out.
Yeah, no shit. Did you meet anyone?
That is none of your business.
I've been gone for 6 months. I think it is my business.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Anna, it is. I'm your older brother. I get to know everything about you. That's the rule. Remember?
Well, I don't play by those rules anymore.
Anyway, do you want to meet the people I've been travelling with?
Yes, I heard a little about it when I got home.
Hopefully everything negative.
Almost entirely.
Well, I can assure you all the negative things are wrong. And then I open the door. Everyone, this is Anna de Axton Alexander Arnold the First.
She was a little hesitant, but she just looks into the room and sees everyone. A lot of people that look like individuals that she's never seen before. Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, and they don't bite, Jesus Christ.
Oh, unless that... you ask me to.
Very forward. She'll take a hesitant step into the room. So.
Oh, it is Gaik still on the balcony.
Yeah, Gaik, Gaik.
Mike, Gaik, you walk back in right this moment.
I would have heard the footsteps. I'm still standing on the balcony, like, with my hood up. I haven't taken it off since we first left. And I'll probably leave it for a minute. And then I'd go and head in.
All right, you take a step inside and see Anna there with Alistair by the door and the rest of your group.
Just give her a nod and kind of shuffle in.
Go on, everyone, introduce yourselves.
My name is Aria. Nice to meet you. I hear you're quite the troublemaker.
Of course he'd say that.
I mean, it's true. Am drawn towards troublemakers. Pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Zuko like stands up straight and bows. And I am Prince Zuko. It is lovely to meet you.
Your Majesty.
Well, I also...
What prince doesn't wear a crown in his head?
Oh, pardon me, and I just go in my bag and get out that crown. If you would prefer it.
My apologies, Your Majesty.
Don't worry, I'm too a fan of a troublemaker.
I think we'll get on rather well then.
I'm sure there'll be lots of stories to share.
On the contrary, I am not a troublemaker. things like Storm, friends, and you can call me Storm.
What an interesting name. Does it come from something?
Our names come from the approximation of our birth. So I was to get into it. There was a giant scorpion attack, quite literal. That's where the stings come from, and it was in a turbulent storm. Hence the name.
Very unique. My name comes from a name that my parents wanted to give me.
I see.
Because it has weight to it. I'm sure Alistair knows exactly what I'm talking about.
Yes.
For those of us who don't?
A lot of weight. You can tell the story. It's your name, after all.
Our family likes to keep names in the family.
Right. Wait, what does that mean?
That seems like that's going a rather strange route. What I mean is that we are named after our ancestors.
Oh,
because of
course.
Their great deeds.
I see.
Yeah, what Storm, what the f- would you... That's...
I don't know. I've heard things about your human...
I want to know more about your other friends, please.
Yes, that's...
I'm Gaiak, and I go to, like, reach my hand out and sort of catch a glimpse of the talons and pull my hand back quite quickly, and then gesture to Ryan. This is my sister, Ryan.
Nice to meet you both. Is that everyone?
Oh, there is someone else.
It's Kent Salem.
Where is she?
Where's Everdale?
Oh, there is.
You forgot the
Everdale, but she is. I feel like she needs some alone time at the moment.
Yes, I think she went to her room.
Yeah, you've also got this one over here. She's not very talkative, though. It points to Vargas.
She
like stands up and walks over to Anna and just kind of like sizes her up. She turns and just walks back.
That means she likes you.
Okay. I don't really get to meet new people quite very often. Not as myself, anyway.
Do you want to go for a walk, just us two? Just have a chat?
I think that would be good.
And I'll be back in tech, guys, and I go out and start walking with Anna.
She'll just kind of give a little shy wave and then follow Alistair.
We'll go to like the Druid Park and I'll just nudge on the shoulder. What are you being so shy for? Literally acting like me when I was... And you introduced me to your friends.
I heard why you're here.
Oh. Right. And?
And I think it's dangerous.
I mean, yeah, it would be, but I am here, I'm alive, I've traveled up and down the coast, and I'm still here.
Some people's luck runs out quickly.
Are you scared?
No, not.
Are you worried? Are you worried for your brother?
She's gonna swing a punch at you.
Can I use shield?
you can use shield. Yeah, she just... Poof.
That's I've not fair. Gotten much use to your antics. Anyway, how have you been?
Same old, really.
Does Mum still want you to join?
Yes.
Have you?
And I refuse.
You refuse? Is she still making you go to those lessons, though? You have to be a proper woman?
Can we not talk about that?
But it's funny, though, because seeing you have to, like, stand up straight and walk properly is a sight. Come on.
You're such an ass.
Oh, I've been gone 6 months. I've got some catching up to do. Anyway,
Right, well, if you do, then so do I.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to try and sweep kick you.
I'm going to try and avoid it.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I mean, you don't even need to. She tries to just sweep kick and you kind of just pirouette out of the way.
I've got some much stronger. Almost doesn't say that. You do, sir. Anyway, I do have a thing for you. I know I missed a big event, so I got you something, and I reach into the bag of holding and pull out the case that the owl necklace is in. I've got this for you. See it as a present and an apology for not telling you that I was leaving. And before I give it to her, I just got like that.
Okay.
Come on.
She sort of scowls at you. And then is going to try and like jump and kick off you to grab it. which, wow, these eyes are not rolling good today. She manages to like... land the kick, but as she tries to leap up, you manage to just pull it away from her. Ah.
There we go.
It's alright.
So I was reminded that you're always wrong. It's not an owl, it's an eagle.
She'll put it on. Well, it is nice.
So, I'm guessing nothing interesting has happened while I've been gone.
Well, aside from... Belenor being invaded...
Yes, that was an event that happened.
Father was... obviously disgruntled by it, as you can imagine.
Yeah.
It's been a bit intense here.
How is, like, everyone, like, Otto, Daisy? Are they still here?
They're here, they're alive.
But...
it's been getting harder to escape. I have to be gone shorter periods of the day, otherwise I'm found out. Mother even suggested that she would station someone in my room 24/7. Or 24/10, I suppose.
What? Some just someone in your room, in the corner? Staring?
Yes.
At you?
Well, I don't know if I'd quite put it that way, but yes.
That's gross.
Where did you go?
Yeah, where
from?
The fuck?
Oh, I don't know. I went. Are you two on your own now?
Yeah, we're
they went to.
We're
they were,
you here?
They're in the park. They're in the park.
In the back of the
just
mind.
Out of the bush.
That's gross. Apologies.
seems I'm going to be here for quite a while. Maybe I've got my meeting with mother and father went as smooth as you can expect.
I'm surprised you left it unscathed.
Oh, you made me kiss the ring twice, which is an improvement, I guess. You know, he only called me weak once, which is... I think he's starting to soften up to me.
Must be his old age.
Yes. Mother as stoic as ever, though. It's one word.
I don't know what to tell you. Ever since you left, it's just been...
Shitty?
That's one way of putting it.
I mean, it seems like it's the only way.
I really think he... I think he's preparing me to take your place. I didn't really know how to say it, so I just said it.
That explains why you're acting like that.
Just don't want you to hate me because of it.
I'm not... Don't worry, I'm not gonna hate you. Does that mean you can use magic? Use magic?
No.
Okay, and... okay, like that's... Okay, that's unfair. That's what I'm annoyed with. 13 years of my life, he just had to go at me for not using magic. I can't use magic. Oh, you're useless. And then you come up, you can't use magic, and you're being groomed to take my place.
So I'm useless then?
No. No, I'm not saying that. Don't you do that word mixing thing you do. Plus, you've never, ever wanted to do it. Like... What brought that along?
I don't like what that power does to people. I've seen it with Father. I would never... wish to indulge myself in it. There's so many better things to do with my life.
Why don't you leave?
Because we don't all have the privilege that you do. I'm sorry, that was I didn't mean that.
It's fine.
I know you're angry with him, but at least you get to leave, you get to see the world, and there are times where I thought you wouldn't even return. And for when the fire happened in Still City, we believed you were dead.
I take it my letter didn't make it then.
Not that I know of.
Well, that's interesting. So you're going to be Lady Anna de Axton, head of the church. Or Lady Anna de Axton Alexander Arnold I, head of the church, then.
Not if you take his place.
I feel like it would be funny for you to do it, though. What would you do
really
if he was in charge of the... What would you do if he was in charge of the church, just to spite him?
I would take down every photo of every patriarch and...
We can replace it with pictures of
photos,
dogs.
Photos, images of myself up there.
Oh, images of yourself.
Of course.
I mean... What about me? Any images of me? Like your best brother ever, who got you a necklace and has travelled the world and has many stories to tell you?
Only if they're good stories.
I've got many. Been away for 6 months.
Apparently a lot can happen in 6 months.
Yes, I've been on journeys and you've taken my place. What a thought.
I don't intend to do it, but I can't stop him when he
I mean, you could. It would be messy as hell, but it would. You could.
There are other people to think about.
So I take it when you snuck out, you weren't meeting with Otto, Daisy, and all that.
Sometimes, but not today.
So who are you meeting today? Come on. Come on, you introduced me to Robin. Yes, you can do is tell me.
Why do you assume that it's some romantic...
Because you're escapade. Being shy about it. You're never shy.
I'm just not sure whether or not you're the same person that left here. That's all. Like you said, a lot can happen in 6 months.
Why don't you tell me who they are, and then I can see.
I wasn't seeing anyone. I just like to get away. Time to myself that's not trapped in some shitty room with shitty parents.
So you're not seeing anyone then? That's a shame. Although the new servant boy looks pretty cute, doesn't he? What's his name? Mark? Marcus?
Oh, him. He's a bit weird.
Yeah, but... you're weird. Be a perfect match.
You always did think yourself for the... a lover.
Only until father found out. Anyway, I forgot to... Sorry?
I never got the chance to really tell you... how sorry I was that that happened. It wasn't fair.
Life isn't fair. And I found out recently.
Are you planning on being here long?
Well, I've asked father for a favour, and now I have to do a favour for father.
Of course.
And then he's going to take my favour into consideration, and we go from there.
Sounds about right.
Yes. He's gotten quite old, hasn't he? He's very wrinkly now. I don't remember him like that.
Yes. I suppose we don't know how long he'll be here for.
One can hope. Shouldn't say that, that's my father.
And yet, I'm sure no one would really disagree if they knew.
True. Wait, so if he... jumps off right away, who would take it, me or you? Because you've been, grooming up to do it, but I'm in line, what do we do? Do we fight over it? I can still kick you. I can kick your ass.
It should be a fight to the death.
A fight to the death? Yeah, but that'll just be so quick. I'll just get you like that.
You're so confident in your little tricks, aren't you, Alistair?
Says the one who couldn't even punch me.
Who said that I was trying to?
Then? In the middle of the park, making sure people are seen. Come on then.
I don't give away my
tricks.
Are
you scared?
Alistair.
Are you scared? You being a little chicken?
I'm not 8 anymore, Alistair.
I know.
I'm glad you came back.
Glad I came back and got to see you.
Don't get yourself killed, please. It would be very inconvenient for me.
Do you think I would ever get myself killed? Am I that stupid?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, I only fell off the roof once, and that was my first time sneaking out. So are you going to hold that over me?
That's so funny.
You didn't tell me it was slippery. It doesn't look like that. I can assure you, once you hear my stories, you won't be worried that I will be killed. I'm gonna just take a walk around Dayford and tell her stories, but like mainly just like bigging up myself, being like, I am the main character. Blah 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 blah. I kill every bad guy.
Roll me a.
Oh shit! She's gonna find it out.
Roll me a. What's the word? What's the
performance?
Deception. I'm talking deception here. Yeah, because if you're bigging yourself up.
Do I get to use my actor's feet advantage for this?
Oh no, because you're not playing another character.
I could be playing a storyteller.
Oh, very you play the GM.
Yeah. Let's do this. Deception.
All right.
15. I'm gonna use guidance.
There's a few bits where she's.
Can I use guidance to? Actually, no. That's.
You've already rolled it. Also, I'm pretty sure she would notice that you go, guidance. So as you take a walk through the park and recount some of the adventures, some of which she's like. This is bullshit. We're gonna cut back to the
death,
the inn, whereby I want to know what the rest of you are doing. As Alistair and Anna leave.
Anna,
Anna.
Future reference. It does say on the spell you can roll the die. Before or after making the ability check, but I know she was doing it anyway.
It's already
happened. Yeah, it was the casting. He didn't cast it before the roll. That's why. But you can roll it before or after.
I would
so,
like,
back in the inn.
Yeah, I'd like to talk to Vargas.
Yeah. Why are you looking at me?
I'm just thinking, guys. You're leaving soon with Rai, yes?
That's the plan, yes?
I'm...
Probably tomorrow, if you're not leaving too.
I think we have things tying us here. I'm just curious if you wish to know more about your, aura. You have...
What do you mean?
You have a lot of residual, wild magic. Do you want to know anything about it? You know, it could be beneficial.
What do you have to do to me?
Nothing invasive. I just mean I can help educate you. I'd like to know more. It's the first time I've met someone with
so much... Educate. Do you think that I'm stupid?
No, I didn't say you're stupid, no. You just don't strike me as somebody that cares for the arcane. That's all. That's what I'm saying, yes.
Yes, flashy lights and... Oh, look at me, I can make fire in my hands.
It's mostly what it is, yes. You're not wrong.
She puts down the wooden whittle that she's been doing, and you can see that it... you can see that it's kind of like... she's not really been... paying much attention to it, but you can see that it's like a... It's sort of like a... almost egg-like shape.
Egg shape.
With sort of like intricate designs on it.
No, you're pretty handy with that.
It is all I could do when I was locked in a cell my entire life.
Yes, my condolences, Dad.
And these rats were spiders. Fine. What do you want to tell me?
I don't know. I think I asked you this before, but has anything like manifested from you touching things or in the heat of battle, I assume, when you're the twinned viper. Did anything, say, explode or shift to a different area, turn invisible?
No.
A flood of...
Nothing like that.
Nothing. Interesting. Seems like you must have a dormant spark then. Untrained.
What if I don't want it?
Ah. You...
Can you take it away?
There are ways, but I am not able to do this. You are what you may say cursed, and what I may say gifted. I'm wondering if I can have your permission to communicate with you. You know, I can check in on you from great distance away.
You want to spy on me? That is creepy.
No, I won't be able to see you. Don't worry. I will be merely delivering you a message that is spoken into your ear. Nothing invasive, nothing intrusive. I don't believe in intrusive magic.
I see.
I can check him on you. I know what it's like to have a particular thing thrusted on you at a young age. Something you don't want. It's daunting. You can reply to me and I can help you if anything starts to happen.
Why are you protecting me like this?
I'm a scholar of the arcane. I only wish for people to be able to use it in the safest ways possible. So,
you want to help people?
Well, yes. I want to help people like I had been helped when I was alone and scared, not understanding a particular gift.
You remind me of my brother. Sometimes.
Really? I don't know if that's a very good thing or not. I've heard strange things.
He was a good person. Even if I didn't see him for many years, he was always protecting me and others. He always wanted to escape and help other people like him. So when he didn't return,
there must have been a reason he didn't return. I don't know. I didn't meet him. I was only there for the end of his journey. But, like I said, yes, I don't believe you'll be able to send me contact, but I'll check up on you. I'm sure Gaia could want to do the same if Ora is with you, so we can do a joint checkup.
Okay. Thank you.
Have you ever said that before?
Said what?
Exactly.
I won't tell anyone.
You better not. I mean it.
I promise. I promise on this thousand sands.
Leave me alone, I want to whittle more.
Okay. Any questions? Any tingles? Any vibrations?
Shut up!
Flying fish? Oh, sorry. I'll leave. This is best. I love it. Must be protected.
Well done there, Jay.
well done.
For creating that character.
Yeah. Oh.
Amazing. Meanwhile, the rest of you, is there anything you'd like to do this time? Eridale is currently...
We don't know about that. We don't know. We wouldn't know.
She literally said she'd be right back. She's been gone for 3 hours.
Oh, right.
Did you say that?
Yes, I said I'll be back in a bit. Yes.
I'll be back in a bit.
Oh, I missed that.
With Eridale could mean I'll be back in like 20 years.
Yeah, but when it's Eridale, she says I'll be back in a bit. That means I'm going to leave for a while.
Yeah,
and
it's
like,
a bit like
people who's bad for going to go around the corner to get milk and then.
Has it reached the point where we are looking around thinking, she's been gone for a while?
I mean, at this point, so you got back, that whole escapade probably happened around 3 in the afternoon. Anna would have shown up about 5 or so, so it's probably pushing around 6 or 7.
If it's pushing 7, I feel like we should go and have a look, yeah.
You say 7 hours?
No,
6 or 7 hours. O'clock.
She's been gone for like almost 2-ish hours.
Oh, okay, that's not too bad then.
Not too bad. She said she'd be right back if she's been gone for 2 hours.
She's still got humanoid limbs. She's still...
Does
she?
You don't know that.
I don't know. The tentacles probably ain't out yet.
I'll get Gaiak or Zuko's attention, or I'll get anyone who I'm with's attention. She said she'd be right back, right? I didn't mishear that.
She said she will be back soon. I took that to mean don't uncheck on me, but she's gone. I'm gone for a while.
I mean, she does that quite often, because she'll be back soon and disappears for 10 years.
I don't... Should we...
Maybe it's a good idea,
yeah,
but I don't...
Just to give her a nod.
I don't know if you should lead the way.
No, I'll stay near the back, but yes. I think we should perhaps go check on her.
No... we'll risk another dagger riddle, though.
Alright.
I'll lead the charge out the door towards Eridale's room. Give a little knock.
What are you doing, knocking on the door?
On the door, yeah. Well, Gaiak is.
Sure.
I'll give it him.
Yeah, you knock on the door.
No one has a key.
As you knock on the door to the room, there's no response. I don't believe you locked the door, did you?
I did. I locked the door.
Okay.
Eridale?
You're not on the door.
Eridale? Are you... It's Gaiak. No?
Try and open it.
I look through the keyhole.
Okay, roll me a perception check.
Sorry, Gaiak. Just scooch to your left a little bit. Thank you.
Trying to shimmy with my wings to the side and...
27. Uh-huh.
Yeah, as you look through the peephole, you can see like the sofa and like the closed balcony windows and the bed, and lying on the floor, like kind of with her back towards you by the mirror, is Eridale. She is on the floor. Like, she looks like she's collapsed on the floor.
Oh shit.
Oh dear.
Is she, get in the. getting the thieves' tools out immediately and picking the lock.
All right, roll me a...
Well, that doesn't look good.
Yeah, roll me a...
Yeah, you see Aria look alarmed.
Okay,
What's going on?
16.
All right, yeah, it's not too hard of a lock to unpick. You click the lock with the thieves' tools and kind of like panicking, you're shaking a little bit, and with that in mind, you put the tools in and the lock clicks and the door unlocks.
Push it open.
Aria's picking the lock. I'm going to instinctively have like my hand on my bow, like, because I don't know what's in there.
Push it open.
As you push open the door, you stand in the room. There's nothing else in here, as far as you can tell, like, other than what you expect in the furnishings. But Eridale was on the floor by the mirror.
Running
given
over.
Given that I thought, like, I know we've been being followed, I'm just going to run to the balcony if this room has one and just check that it's all the doors sealed or whatever, that no one's...
Right, run me an investigation check as you get there.
Can I guidance myself and kind of look at Eridale's, like, vitals, you know, check she's breathing, all that kind of stuff?
Sure, roll me a medicine check.
Eridale?
You can do the thing.
Eridale! I'm, like, shaking
her. Zuko? Zuko, you check the doors. It doesn't look like anything's been broken into. It looks like it's still closed and locked from the inside. She's breathing. You can feel like her breathing, like she is alive, but she is unconscious.
Jesus.
Storm, were you following in, or were you still having a conversation in the other room?
The conversation with Vargas had finished by this point, I would have fallen in. Yeah.
All right. So, Aria, you're trying to wake her up?
I'm shaking her and saying her name. Eridale? Hey! I slap her on the cheek.
Okay. As you slap her on her cheek, her eyes, like blink open. What? Like, she awakes instantly.
Huh? Come on.
Except Eridale, you are not in control. Her eyes are purple, and immediately I need Zuko wasn't in the area, but I need Gaiak, Storm, Aria to all make me a intelligence saving throw, please.
Oh my fucking god!
Oh,
that's
not
good.
It's not okay.
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 Dice, guys. Yes! Let's go!
Oh, that might just be the most clutch roll.
Alright.
Me and Gaiak rolled shit.
If anyone rolled bad there, though, we needed it to not be Storm. Because Storm, we need Storm.
Yes, Storm, because Storm can help.
He's the silly boy, and he's smart, and... he's been researching.
Oh my god! He's the anti-Sai.
You look as you awake, Aria, you get the full brunt of it as her eyes kind of glisten purple, and like immediately there is a shock wave of psionic energy that blasts out from her, like just from her, as you take, how much is that?
Fuck me.
That'll be. Oh wow, that's a lot.
Oh no.
Don't say that. What?
So those of you who let me just double check something.
What is happening?
Alright. So Aria, Gaiak, Storm succeeded. Was there anyone else in that blast range? I don't believe so. Kensei, were you in the room? Did you go in the room as well?
I think I said I was nearby, yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to need you to roll me one as well.
Oh boy, that's not going to be great.
Yeah.
Actually, went round twirlers, right? Okay.
The button was pressed.
This mind flayer's got fucking
the button was pressed. It's
potentially take out the two fires.
It is an intelligence saving throw, by the way, Kensei, just so you know.
Yeah, they'll be with me for the next 20 years.
Is it loading slowly?
Oh my god.
But we'll see when you're safe when it comes up. But Aria and Gaiak, at the very least, both of you take, I believe it was...
Right, let's see the damage.
Oh, and Kensei. Oh.
22 psychic damage.
Okay.
Straight to the heart.
Brain.
Okay.
Into and Kensei, Aria, and Gaiak. 22 psychic damage, and all of you are stunned.
Do I take any damage?
You don't take any damage. Those of you that, like, you feel the effect, and immediately you, like, that sensation is familiar. It was like that mind blast that the Illithid did to you when you were down in the... down in the Underdark.
Do I hear or see anything, or is this completely...
Well, I mean, they all shout in pain as they kind of... Their mind is racked with agony, and those of you are stunned. So I'm just going to make note of that as Aradol's body kind of like leaps up off the ground to face towards you. Her eyes are glossed over, and as far as you can tell, like, it's not Aradol behind them.
Okay, do I get action?
No, because that's where we're going to end.
Oh my fucking god, what happened?
You've been snatched. You've been snapped.
I miss endings like this where we get absolutely bamboozled.
You've been mind snatched.
So just gonna write this
down. Oh my god!
Oh,
the bear.
To make us wait a week. Please, can we just not go on? Can we please carry on?
I like the image of just you guys just having this battle to the death while Alice is having a nice little play in the park.
Yep.
Yep. To his sister about how amazing
while you guys are just fighting to the death.
Not okay.
Guess it's Kensei, Aria, Gaiak are stunned.
Oh, fucks.
Alright, yep, so... Just wanted to make sure I made note of that right then.
Oh, well, I'm
so, yep, that is, that's where we're going to end the session.
God damn.
Fucking
hell.
A bit of a cliffhanger there. Just a bit.
I realised, like, for the last shit. 2 minutes, I wasn't breathing, dude.
How did the meeting with my parents become... like the second worst thing that happened.
Well, I mean, in one way, Arya's finally got her answers.
Yeah, you just found out. Oh, yeah.
Let's just tell your parents that Aradel was the spy, and we'll just.
Yeah, let's put her under the bus. Let's throw her under the bus. It's here. Is it police? It's this one. It's here.
It's just the fact that, like, you're. Your mother was told, oh yeah, if this one wakes up, like, you're fucked. And everyone's like, poke.
What does this button do?
It's saying probably wouldn't. She said it probably wouldn't.
Yeah, the question being probably.
Listen, if I have something living in my body that is foreign, I'm not just going to leave it alone. I'm going to be like...
Maybe get it.
All right. Well, on that, we're gonna wrap up there real quick.
Oh so, my god!
Thank you for joining us for this week. We'll have to find out what's gonna happen next
Stress.
Week and see where this absolute madness and carnage leads to. So until
you
then, remember.
You've yushed her.
Stay dirty. See you next week.
Yeah. Hey.